I don't give a goddamn fuck that you shot him. I'm glad that you shot him. I'm fucking glad that he's dead.
Nocturnal Animals is one of my favorite movies of 2016. Not because it maintains the thematic darkness throughout the film, but also because it draws parallel between three separate narratives through very common yet uncommon techniques of metaphors and symbology. To look at it, the theme of the movie is revenge. The structure of the film relies heavily on symbology, and even many of the transitions from one scene to the other are either match cuts or metaphorical ones. The film runs on three narratives, which are evenly distributed throughout the film. The first is Susan's current situation. The second is the story in the novel, and the third is the flashback. The movie starts with one of the most different opening credits in film history, which exhibits a bunch of naked and obese women dancing, which Susan later terms as junk, regardless of the subjectivity perspective of art.
So perfect with all this junk culture that we live in.
It's junk it is. Junk. Total junk.
Now let's go according to the timeline of the whole thing. The first is flashback. Susan is an aspiring artist who is emotionally strong, but not very determined about the things she dreams about. She cares more about what the society would think of her, while Edward, on the other hand, is an emotionally sensitive and a romantic guy, who is brittle to others' opinions, but is quite determined in what he wants to achieve. Things start like any love story does. They seem very romantic and hopeful at the start, but slowly things start coming to light. Susan's mother warns her of marrying Edward, calling him weak. Regardless of it, she marries him, and that's when the main problems start. The clashes begin between an undetermined artist and a determined writer. And when the fights begin to happen regularly, she comes across another handsome man named Hutton, after which she decides to break up with Edward despite him pleading and begging her not to leave him. The relationship fully terminates when Susan aborts Edward's child with Hutton's presence, and Edward catches her red-handed. The second is the present. 19 years later, Susan is a successful but not a satisfied artist. She is married to Hutton, and her relationship with him has lost the inertia it had when it started. Unlike before, Hutton has stopped giving his shoulder to Susan during her tough times. She shares her thoughts with one of her colleagues who does not take her seriously at all. But again, Susan has no one else to share her thoughts and feelings with. With Edward entering her mind and those thoughts getting stronger and stronger after she starts reading his novel, she gets more frustrated and anxious day by day. The feeling of being powerless and unloved spreads in her like a venom as she finishes reading the novel. The third is the novel Nocturnal Animals. Tony Hastings is on his road trip with his family while they come across three local hillbillies led by Ray Marcus. After creating nuisance, they brutally rape Tony's wife Laura and his daughter India while Tony manages to escape. A year later, a policeman Bobby contacts a guilt-wrecked Tony to identify his family's killers, but those three criminals are released for the lack of evidence. Bobby then reveals a plan to Tony to kill those accused outside of law, citing his lung cancer as an excuse. Tony agrees to the plan, and Lou is shot by Bobby while Tony shoots Ray while getting hit by him and blinded in the process. He wakes up in the morning to find Ray dead and his brain hemorrhaged, as he falls on his gun, eventually killing himself. Now there are two things to notice. Number one, the scenes from the novel are evenly spread in the movie, the transitions between of which are mostly match cuts or an equally impactful moment. Number two, the past of Edward and Susan only begins after the murder of Tony's family, and that's when we realize that Edward and Tony are played by the same actor. All the other characters in the real world and the novel world are distinct. Let's look at the metaphors of revenge. When Susan opens the manuscript, she gets a paper cut, which indicates that this is going to be something terrifying and gruesome. In the novel, the characters metaphorically represent the people in the real world. Tony is the sensitive and the sweet Edward who is extremely nice to people and is not able to hurt others easily. Tony's wife Laura is a representation of Susan that he loved. Tony's daughter India represents Edward's and Susan's unborn child. Ray represents Susan, who turned insensitive and selfish, while Ray's gang members Lou and Turk are Hutton and Susan's mother Anne, who directly or indirectly became responsible for the killing of Tony's wife and daughter. Bobby is the voice in Edward's head, continuously telling him to stop being nice and sensitive and face the situation. Bobby helps Tony kill Ray and his gang, eventually letting him have his revenge. Also, there are several elements in the novel that make appearances in the real world. The couch on which Laura and India's bodies lie is the same couch on which Susan sat while emphasizing strong disbelief in Edward. The car during the final breakup scene is the same car which Ray drove to push Tony and his family off the road. Laura's necklace with the cross is the same one which Susan wears. Through the violent and disturbing chain of events in the novel, Edward induces pain and anxiety in Susan, following which he finally lets Susan go. If we compare the book to the real world, it becomes quite evident that Edward wrote this and dedicated this to Susan to make her more guilt-wrecked and tells her indirectly through stories that the old and nice Edward is dead. But when Susan mails him about a meetup to which Edward agrees, she goes to the restaurant. She keeps waiting while Edward never shows up. This was Edward's final act of vengeance. By giving her a final ray of hope and never actually helping her, he makes her regret her decision. He makes her feel the same helplessness he felt while his wife and his child were taken away. Nocturnal Animals is a classic example of how situations in the movies can be elevated using metaphors, and the way Tom Ford uses them is amazing. The use of metaphors in movies can be tricky, especially when they have a direct effect on the character's emotions. While writing anything, the writer has to treat the characters as humans with real feelings and emotions. Otherwise, they would become nothing but props.